Walk in Jerusalem, just like a charm. Walk in Jerusalem, just like a
Good morning, everybody. Hope you can all hear me. Okay. Welcome to our choir service this morning. As you're about to find out, nearly everything that happens in this service is a piece of music. There will be very little talking, and I hope you will sing with us all along the way. In keeping with that, our land acknowledgement will also involve a piece of music. I will first just say that we acknowledge that we live and exist on the land of the Western Abenaki people, and we try our best to honor their culture and their heritage. And so we will now sing This Pretty Planet, Song About the Earth, by Tom Chapin. And it's a round, and we did this about a month ago. The choir will be split into three parts, one over there, two in the middle, three over there. And we invite you to kind of latch on to one of them and participate in the round with us. And the words will be up on the screen. So here is This Pretty Planet.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for singing with us. I'll just wait a minute until this turns on. Right. Okay, good. Everybody hear me all right? Wonderful. So welcome to the Champlain Valley Unitarian Universalist Society. My name is Ronnie Romano. I am the director of music here, and this is our choir. Yeah. We're sad that a few people can't be here with us today. Traveling, illness, various things. We're missing Liam Badger Greenwood. We're missing Marnie Wood. We're missing Lynn Ballman and several others who kind of sang with us throughout the year and might have dropped off. So just know that the sound you hear today is more than actually what you see and hear at this moment. It was built by many others who couldn't be with us. So welcome. Please remember to turn off your cell phones or put them in worship mode, as people often say. I always think that's very funny. Happy Father's Day. It is Father's Day. I'll just briefly draw your attention to a few pathways to connection. These are all in your order of service, so I won't really go into detail much. Of course, you can always stick around for social hour after the service is over downstairs for good treats. Lots of exciting things coming up. There's a World Music Day. There is the Pride Parade. You can read all about those things in your program there. Really exciting stuff. So we are just so happy that you're here with us today. And I'm gonna stop talking so that we can continue singing. The next song, our gathering song, is called I'm Gonna Lift My Sister Up. And we invite you to sing along with us. It's pretty simple to pick up. Words will be up there. And I'll invite you to stand as you are able for this one. Here we go.
I'm gonna lift my sister up. She is not ready.
Thank you for singing with us. Good. Hope you're having fun. So next, we come to two more typical elements of our service, which will again be replaced with songs. So the call to worship and the chalice lighting this morning. First, will be Come Sing a Song with Me. And we've got the wrong number there in the printed bulletin. It's actually number 346, if you're looking for it in your gray hymnal. Words will also be on the screen. So that will be our call to worship, a call to singing, Come Sing a Song with Me. And then we will light our chalice and sing Rise Up, O Flame. And then I will tell you about what is happening in the time for all ages. So, Time for All Ages. Some of you might remember, if you attended this service last year, the choir service, that what we did for the Time for All Ages was I led you in a vocal warm-up, exactly like the choir does every Thursday night at rehearsal. And we're going to do the same thing this year, so this really is a Time for All Ages to participate in. This will kind of give you a sense of what choir rehearsal's like, actually. Maybe it'll make you say, oh, I want to join choir. Maybe. So, of course, stay seated if you need to, but I always invite people to stand and stretch first when doing a warm-up. So, stand and stretch. Go all the way up to the sky, and then maybe go over to the side. Try not to hit your neighbor. Go the other way. Oh, boy. I also like to grab my hands gently behind my back and just kind of pull the shoulders open a little bit. That's really good for singing. Gets a lot of space in there for all the air and everything. Sometimes just a gentle massage of the face. We have a lot of muscles in the face. I don't think we remember that we hold a lot of tension there. We need to be nice and relaxed. And just make sure everything is nice and light, not holding any tension anywhere. Good. And then we normally end with just a couple of nice, slow, deep breaths together. So I'll just invite us to all breathe in and out. And another in and out. And one more breath all the way in and all the way out. Choir will help you out here because they're very familiar with all of these warm-ups. So we're going to start with something very straightforward here. We're just going to be on ooh, 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 and just going up and down. Ooh, 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 ooh. Then we'll take a breath and we'll do it in a higher key and we'll keep going. Nice and slowly. Now breathe. So next, we normally do something that goes in the other direction, going down. So this is, we're going to start on E, and then we're going to switch to O. So E, 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 O. So the first ones are nice and short. E, 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 O. That's the idea. Here we go. E, 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 O. Going down. E, 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 O. E-E-E-E-O. E-E-E-E-O. E-E-E-E-O.
there's some good singing out there. You better be careful. If you sing too well, I might just, you know, yeah, you'll be recruited. But, that's right. That's right. you'd probably not let me off the hook if I didn't do this one. This is, I know. You just say, I know, over and over. I know, 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 I know. So one more time, why don't we demonstrate that, choir? I know, 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 I know. Here we go. I know, 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 I know. I know, 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 I know. I know, 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 I know. I know, I know, I know, I know, I know, I know. We're gonna switch to I saw. I saw, 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 one more. I saw, 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 I saw. Good. Now just one more thing to give you a little taste of harmony in choir warm-ups. So, this next one goes like this. E, A, and A. E, A, A. The last bit is all on A, okay? So that's the option for lower voices, like basses and altos. And there's also a higher version for sopranos and tenors. E, A, A. The same thing and you come down in harmony. So let's just demonstrate that, choir. Let's do the lower one and and the higher one. So you pick whatever one works for you, but you get lovely harmony. So here it is, breathe together and last one, here we go. Wonderful, wonderful. Warm up over. Everybody can take a seat. I just, you know, there's an incredible, like, something when you get a room with this many people in it and they all sing. The air just hums. It's really amazing. I hope you feel that. Wow. Every single one of you should join the choir. Okay. Good. So, let's see. Is Poppy here? Are there any kids that need to leave? Okay. Maybe she left already. All right. Well, I guess we don't have any kids to sing out then, so. Oh, do we have to sing anybody out? Oh, okay. Well, you know the tune.
Thank you.
Okay, so now I'm going to stop speaking and invite Neil up to introduce the offering.
Juneteenth is tomorrow. Little history. On June 19th, 1865, Union General George Granger sailed into Galveston Harbor with 2,000 Union troops to bring Texas back under the control of the federal government. Upon landing in Galveston, General Granger informed enslaved Texans of their freedom under the Emancipation Proclamation issued more than 2 years earlier. Long overlooked in history, this historic date has been celebrated as Black Independence Day. General Granger's order promised absolute equality of personal rights and the rights of property between former masters and slaves. It also clarified the relationship between shareholders and enslaved as one between employer and hired labor. The actual end of slavery in the United States did not occur until December of 1865 with the ratification of the 13th Amendment to the United States Constitution. This year, the nation celebrates Juneteenth as the newest federal holiday. Now, these rights that were promised in the Emancipation Proclamation, and in many generals moving around telling slaves they were free, and also with the 13th and 14th Amendment, these rights are still not secured. And that's one of the things that the NAACP does to secure those rights. So I would ask you to give generously today to help support the work of the NAACP. Thank you.
I just wanted to make a statement before I sang for you, and that is, thank you very much, the way you presented that. It's really something for all Americans, black and white. And it was many years, I grew up in Youngstown, Ohio, that they thought the end of slavery only pertained to black people. But white people participated, so we must each acknowledge that it's over. And secondly, I just want to say, living in Vermont for these past 23 years, I know this wasn't planned. I was not going to continue to remain here. But on a day like today, Father's Day, I'm not only thinking of my biological father, my stepfather. Fred Rogers was my surrogate father. And Francis and Paul Stone are my Middlebury fathers. They're part of the reason I want to stay here. Amen. As for CVUUS. Well. No more slavery chain for me. No more. No more, no more slavery chain for me. Many thousands gone. gone. Now there'll be no more yet dying, no more, Lord, no more, no more slavery, chain for me, many thousand gone. No more driver's lash for me. No more, no more, no more driver's lash for me. Many thousand gone. Oh, there'll be no more, yeah. Woo! Dying, no more, Lord, no more, no more driver's lash for me. Many thousands
Well, we come now to the time for milestones and passages. And here I have a whole stack of them. So here I go. First we have one from Hillary Hatch. Wanted to let Poppy know that we are embracing her and her family in our arms, hearts, and minds on this first Father's Day without her dad. Amen. Okay, let's see here. Is that a yes during Sunday services? I think so. From Elio, I invite you to join Virgin's trans and queer youth most impacted for an official celebration of queer joy. An anti-trans speaker will be at VUHS in Virgin's, and we are countering their hate with a lot of love. This will be a peaceful and joyful action with de-escalators present. We will keep our children safe and refuse to interact with haters. We call on our community to join with us. 6 o'clock on Tuesday. Thank you. Thank you. At the high school, yes, Virgin's High School. Good. Okay. And from a choir member, I, perhaps we, sing to you from my heart. I share my deep sorrow and joy with two of today's pieces. May it offer opening to how they land for you upon this last week's visits. My brother interrupted me from singing, I'm gonna lift my sister up, negating my heartfelt support. I experience both extremes in No One Is Alone, familial aloneness from my sister and being embraced fully by my visiting lifelong friend. And from Paul and Francis. Just recently, we attended our granddaughter Emily Stone's white coat ceremony at the University of Florida, where she just completed her second year of veterinary school. Her love is with small animals, especially cats. Emily was a CVUUS nursery care person when she attended the high school in Middlebury a while ago. And at the same time, another granddaughter, Moira Picour, graduated from Meredith College in Raleigh, North Carolina. She was an RE participant a while ago. And as we have already mentioned, Juneteenth is tomorrow, June 19th, signifying freedom for African Americans by the abolition of slavery. Hopefully, true freedom will prevail someday. Amen. So, one more. Yes, one more from Kate Gridley. Yes. Huh? Okay. I am back, fresh back, from a 2,000-mile truck drive, towing a car across the South from Florida to Tucson, Arizona, with my adult son. The environmental degradation along highways that are falling apart was discouraging beyond belief. The natural beauty and the people were exceptional and wonderful. I relish the time in the truck with my son, and I am so grateful to be home. Good. Amen. And as always, we acknowledge that there are many unspoken joys and concerns. And before we move into our meditation today, which will be kind of a guided humming meditation that I'll invite you into a minute, I will just leave you with a brief moment of silence to reflect on any unspoken milestones and passages that may be in your heart. So for our meditation today, we're going to be humming along while I provide some color and background on the piano. This is something I do sometimes in rehearsal to get the choir to sing notes more in tune, to really get them to listen into one note. It can help to sing that same note over a variety of different things on the piano and really hear how it can change. So I'll invite all of you in the room right now to just hum together on this note, and you just breathe whenever you want. You can take little breaks, you can come back in. You just hum, breathe, relax, and listen. So I'll just invite you all to just hum this note together. And now I'll invite you to sing in the Teal Hymnal, number 1009, Meditation on Breathing. Thank you. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. Here comes the choir concert. Pretty much. Not that this already hasn't been choir concert. We're going to perform two little sets of music for you. And I had tentatively set room for a reflection in between of them, but that'll be about a 30-second reflection at this point, because we're we got a lot to sing. So we will first offer two spirituals arranged by our very own Francois, Steal Away and Somebody Knocking at Your Door. And that will be followed by Lord Don't Move This Mountain, which we sang several months ago. Wonderful, wonderful, fun song. So here comes our first set of pieces. This is going to be the shortest reflection ever because we have four more pieces to share with you. But the one very important thing that I just have to say is that a choir is an instrument made of people, made of human beings. And as a singer, your body is your instrument. You know, it's not like playing the piano or violin or anything like that where you're just getting sound out of something else. I mean, you are the instrument. You are the resonator. And your instrument is attached to all of you, your brain, your thoughts, your feelings, your experience, everything. And for me, that's why singing is the most special form of music making, because it's the whole person. And when you take a group of people and put them together, all of those individual human instruments form one large choral instrument. And it's just magical. So we're so happy we could share that with you. And here comes more music. We just sang this last week. This is Diretong, which means so they say.
Thank you. one-man show here. I am.
Thank you.
You can call this next one our closing hymn, if you will. This is Every Time I Feel the Spirit. I don't think there are words for this or anything, but it's Francois' arrangement, and sing something. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you so, so much. We have a very quick benediction for you. It is 1 minute long, and then you are out of here. Sorry for keeping you so late. We just had so much to share. So this is Peace I Leave With You by Amy Beach. This is our benediction for today. Thank you for clapping and singing, by the way.
Thank you again, everybody. Thank you. Oh, sure, sure. I was just going to say, I will play a postlude. You can leave if you want. You don't have to sit and listen.
So before Ronnie plays his postlude, I've been asked to, on the behalf of the congregation, to offer our deepest and sincerest thanks for all that he has given to us in the last 2 years. He has really lifted us up, and he deserves our deepest thanks.